Okay, I'm gonna just walk through, I'm not gonna show you the chitow trigger point release, you've seen it twice now, you know what to do, but I am gonna just walk you quickly through the differences in glute max, glute med, and TFL when treating, because you have to put these muscles on a stretch, it adds a different dimension to this treatment. So glute max, as you know, when you're palpating, this is perfect in sideline, you have great access here with good sideline draping. So if you were doing some massage here, coming along, and you found a trigger point here, she's already in a bit of stretch because, as you know, glute max does extension of the hip, and she's already in flexion of the hip. So this is actually a great way to locate trigger points in this muscle because it's already on a stretch, and the top bands will be a little more obvious. So that would be great. This is how you put a stretch, and then just get her, when she needs to do the active range of motion afterwards, you would just get her to flex the leg up and then move it back and just do some gentle movements like that. And you can just hold on and just guide them through that if they need that. Okay, and then for glute med is mainly an abductor of the hip, but it also does medial rotation. So as we're palpating the glute max, we come around the iliac crest. You'll notice at kind of at the top of the iliac crest or right on the side here, you'll notice the glute max starts to dip in, and there's a bit of a triangle there that your fingers almost dip into it. That's glute med. And if you're not sure, then you resist the action of it, right? So we want to resist abduction. So Paige, I'm gonna get you to push up into my hand here. Good. And that pops right out into my hand. I could also get her to resist medial rotation, which I will do down at her ankle. So resist me here and press up, good. So that confirms, there's two ways to confirm there that you're on glute med. And then you could get them to, again, do some active range of motion. And the flexion extension that we did with glute max would work for this, even though it's an abduction type thing. You could get them to abduct their leg, but that's actually kind of exercise. You could get them to do that though, that's fine. But flexion extension will help move that glute med as well. Tensor fascia lata, the easiest way to find that is to come right off of the ASIS. So find the ASIS and come laterally out onto it. And its main action is to flex the hip. So then I'm gonna get you to resist me here. Good. And notice I'm using my entire body to do this because people's legs are strong. Just like you learn in assessment, don't let me move you, don't let me move you. When you're doing isometrics, you wanna make sure that you're really giving them a proper cue by putting your hand in the exact right place and resisting that movement with good clarity. That's what I'm trying to say in an unclear kind of way. So that popped out into my hands when I resisted flexion there. So I would treat a trigger point there. You can also follow that down the IT band and easily treat anything in the IT band in this position. If you wanted to put that TFL on a stretch, you could lift the leg and bring it back a little bit into a bit of extension to put that muscle on a stretch. You could also remove the pillow between her knees and bring the leg back down. You could also do that for glute med because it's an abductor. So if you want to put the leg into a little bit of adduction, you just remove the pillow and then her knee falls forward, that's adduction. So then you can treat glute med that way. So just a few little tips and tricks when doing a chitow trigger point release on these three muscles.